Thank you. I know there was a seat question.
Or if not,
but it, It may be. It's fine. I don't know.
I'm not coordinating
this stuff.
Yeah, no worries.
I'm just ask him.
Yeah, really. I am not sure.
I mean, ask him.
He'll know. Still think they close the damn hall too early.
Which hall?
Yep. Yeah. 6 o'clock.
Yes.
Pretty cheap.
Yeah. How's your art acquisition going?
It's going better now.
Yeah.
I'm undecided between three different oil paintings. Baseball card. cards. Yeah.
charge to a shard that gains gain a charge. Does this trigger twice? Not gain two charges, gain a charge, gain a charge. Gain health, which if I had Paladin, I'd help. Also, this combination of shards makes... I can get some really stupid stuff. This is the horrible, horrible monster. I think this is an 18 shard deck. I think with three of these.
Thank you. I
your priority. Norvik, is it your priority? For this guy. And that lets me lose.
I was literally just talking about the noise you made the first time you saw that card. What's the
Spell Shield Swift Strike? And Spell Shield Swift Strike, the reason being it's ridiculous. My card's alone. What? Bugs? Time bugs! Time bugs.
Their troops fight with feather.
So bad.
That's so good.
So bad.
So good.
So bad. Turn 3 Mind Call into turn 4 this isn't bad.
What's that?
Turn 3 Mind Call into turn 4 this.
Yes, yes, that would be amazing. How many Spirit Oracles did you get?
3.
How is it that everyone passes those?
I think they're amazing. They're just high cost.
The other guy that I know knocked out, and the last draft had four of them. Like, how does that even happen?
It's way better than like Rudon. That's amazing.
People haven't played the demo decks and realized the power of Spirit Oracle?
Yeah, maybe. That could be it, I suppose.
What?
I mean, I can think of last year like being insane because no one had ever touched the arena
right.
before.
Now they can play at home. There's no reason to go to GenCon.
Yeah, why would I? We're all going to spoil everything.
They don't really care about posters or whatever, so I guess. I'm hoping that's it, and it's not just a diminished interest situation.
I think the play at home is a big one.
Yeah, I think so too. I think that's probably the biggest factor. Is that you can play
it. Probably like less. If you draft it, then you probably definitely play it. I'm already more
involved. So playing into this combat turn.
Also, Corey's in it.
Yeah, Corey's in it.
He'll probably be drawing up this move, so.
Give it that surf strike.
One thing that I can't say for sure
that surf strike.
Is they've had a steady supply of interest. Like, it's never been just empty. So, that's good.
And, and a lot of the people that have been coming up and playing the leagues are people that have never heard of Hex before.
Right. Yeah, and I should say, it's never been empty, even including us. Like, there have always been new players around.
Honestly, maybe I take that off. Last year it was just nothing but us Kickstarter backers.
Right. Right.
And the lines were so crazy, anyone that thought, hey, what's Hex, they didn't want to jump in that.
I mean, it's actually kind of weird. People are like, oh shit, there's a huge line, that must be the best game ever, I'm going to jump in on that shit. So, I mean,
there's two sides.
Let's do something.
Oh, that seems good.
I feel like we're streaming. We're streaming, Hacky. We're just watching.
You're gonna see this. You're gonna see this on Tuesday. I'm just gonna play this video and talk over it.
Okay. I should put my face in it.
Camera bomb. I'm just gonna die to this Briar Legion. Slowly.
I wonder if I can set my hat on top of
it. Is he gonna kill it? Is he gonna kill? He's gonna kill it.
Did he put the pinging thing on it just to
yes.
Yes.
Yeah, I think so.
Wow. That's a commitment. Cool as that.
I guess we'll do the good old boulder group.
If it doesn't get pinged.
I mean, I can't blame him. Spirit Oracle is ridiculous. It's so good. Especially that stupid interceptor bot. Oh my god.
Because one shard, and he's beyond being pinged back in the board. Look, burn.
Three. The guy had three Oracle things and an interceptor bot. Two interceptor.
Remember when you were saying how you think the high operation is going to be dead? And you can't see how
that.
You said, like, you better see how that conflict is going to happen.
I think I said that. I think someone else said that.
Definitely said that.
I think someone else said that.
It was definitely you.
Why would I say that? I like my creation. I mean, it's not great. Yeah, it's not great, but it's not terrible. I mean, it still gets you potentially X troops on the board. That's pretty strong.
There's no round, is there? We haven't seen that constantly. It may have gotten pushed back to PvE.
What's that?
The constantly creates wild shards every time.
That would be too strong. Especially with the shard shit. Charge.
It feels weird to have no real ramp.
Yeah.
It's like not a single ramp card.
But ping me at the end of each of my turns. Except for Jack.
Good fix, actually. I know it is actually pretty useful.
And charges everything. everybody's going to use their charge power so much more.
Yeah, the charge thing is awesome. That's a good change. Yes, I agree.
Here we go.
I'm not a fan of that change. I was talking to them about that last night.
Not either, but that's what it is. We'll see what format you give me.
But we also haven't seen everything. There might be some decent, not that.
Yeah, I still think especially with that 2 plus roll card advantage, obviously. But the problem is there's the stupid paper trail. But that forces you to move diamond or wild or find something.
Really?
Because by the time you get your extra draws going, you can probably just get rid of the one. It costs you the 2 plus roll card. Huh? But that just means you're stuck into playing as Rebels.
I think you probably need to if you play Camels.
Rebel hidden troops?
They're not in play yet.
That's true, you don't have to play at all.
So like, can you play it? Do you play Marvel songs in that
deck?
That is more, I mean, that card totally goes on. It's like the worst thing in the world. You still probably play the charge card just because it's a quick speed.
Yeah,
I think it's more about like, even if it was on the board, like, think about how it interacts. You can draw one per turn. So you draw your one on your turn, and then they play something you can't draw another one. So you can still get reasonable advantage.
Did you win a free draft at some point? Is that what that was? You found the clause about the free draft the hardest?
Yes, I won the first free draft.
Poster!
No, that's what I said. I'm like, sweet, where's the poster? They're like, oh, we don't give him free draft. The concentrate is so hard on that first draft.
that's hilarious.
So yes, I've won 3 statue drafts.
That's hilarious. Let's gain 2 charges, give my 14 flight.
I think it was a lane. I thought your deck there was superior, so I just, that was wise. I had a better matchup. That's really all it was. I think my deck was just not very strong. Like, it was overall strong, but in that bad, like, that was. Like I said, I thought your deck was just solid. It helps if I got a good one, so.
Sets 3 and 4, and then we're done with all these cards.
Yeah, but they didn't cycle out. It's still constructive play.